journalists that Antifa love to hate on. That's pretty much how I found out or even noticed him, because he's kind of nondescript, but he got a big following on the media, but it's sort of like a pundit, but Andy Ngo.
Yeah, I know Andy Ngo.
What do you think of him?
I like him.
Yeah. Well, his dad was a cop, is what I just found out, because I watched his C-SPAN of him talking at CPAC or something. And I was like, now it's all making sense. He's kind of got it in the blood. Like, he's just got an interest in the minutiae of following all the characters. But he's been getting slammed with death threats. I saw his account said yesterday. And I think Haley Addison has been death threatened. My friend down there in Portland, he's been threatened. And I don't know how anyone manages that much stress.
It's difficult, but not impossible.
Yeah, right. So it's like you have to up your game a little bit to like a military precision level. I asked my friend, he's doing better, he said, off the bottle for time being, I hope forever. But he was in National Guard and I was like, what did they train you? He hated it, he wasn't really good at it, but I mean he was, but he was just more of a hippie little kid, you know, kind of get him some green kind of years. But I was like, what did they train you in the military for, like, de-escalating your own stress and stuff? And he was just like, I'm tired. And he's like, 10 push-ups. I don't know. But he doesn't even understand what I'm doing in terms of my politicking and my researching and writing and stuff. But I told him, I'm trying to explain to him, I sit there and research stuff. I try to give it to journalists. They can make it go big. I'm nobody. I get no credit and no money. But I'm trying to turn the tide of events by getting the information flowing in the right direction.
Right.
And it's like takes a village of teamwork and people working on all different kinds of levels behind the scenes. But I'm a big reader, so I just like sitting there at the computer for hours and hours and hours and poring over shit and knowing why it's important and who it goes to or who understands it. Like, I was kind of pleased with Shane Kavanaugh. I sort of had a prior relationship with on a professional level, because he called out to me when he wanted to write an article on the McKelvey incident, and he understood why it was important, that you can't just trust a randomized activist to be your godhead leader like Luke Skywalker without a little vetting. And it's almost like the compassion that I learned to have for myself or my friends or whatever. Like, most of my friends are felons, and I may come off as judgmental, but I might feel safer that way, you know?
Right.
Like, I might feel safer with someone with a realistic understanding of how the real world works. And I think McKelvey's just like overly sensitive and flipped out so much, and I'm like, you don't have to flip out that hard. But I mean, his management of the Sarah Ayanaro campaign, I just not been into that. It's like they run their hipster activism